China, telling the Philippines to be more prudent on the Taiwan issue. This after Beijing expressed strong opposition over President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s congratulatory message to Taiwan's president-elect Lai Ching-te. During an event organized by the Chinese embassy, Ambassador Wang Xilian reiterated, Manila must recognize the One China policy.
The One China policy is the political premise on which China established and developed diplomatic relations with the Philippines. So we should strengthen instead of shape such foundation. Next. So we hope that the Philippine side will stay committed to the One China policy pursued by successful Philippine administrations since the establishment of diplomatic ties between China and the Philippines, and respect China's internal affairs and handle the Taiwan question prudently.
As for their maritime row, China calls on the Philippines to meet Beijing halfway in addressing the issue.
Maritime issues are not the entirety of our relations. We hope that the Philippines will meet China halfway, manage maritime differences properly through dialogue and consultation, and jointly maintain peace and stability in the South China Sea and the sound development of bilateral relations.
Meanwhile, delegations from the Philippines and China met in Shanghai Wednesday for talks on their maritime dispute. The Foreign Affairs Department says the two sides had frank and productive discussions aimed at de-escalating tensions. The two countries agreed to calmly deal with incidents at sea and improve maritime communication. Philippine Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro slams China's foreign ministry for what he called gutter talk. In a statement, Teodoro called out China for resorting to insulting President Marcos and the Filipino people. But he adds he's not surprised that an agent of a party and system of government incompatible with the Philippine way of life would go that far and low. China's foreign ministry earlier warned Marcos not to play with fire and to read more to better understand the Taiwan issue. In other news, signature forms supporting a people's initiative to amend the constitution submitted to the Philippine poll body by hundreds of cities and municipalities. But the Election Commission warns it could void signatures that are proven to have been illegally obtained. Victoria Tulad with this report.
In these photos from the local office of the Commission on Elections, or COMELEC, in Legazpi City, Albay, election officers can be seen inspecting signature forms for the People's Initiative. Similar forms were also sent to the COMELEC offices in Leyte, Samar, Agusan del Norte, and Maguindanao del Sur, as well as in Manila and Quezon City. The People's Initiative is one of three ways to amend the Constitution, and for this process to get off the ground, proponents need signatures from 12% of registered voters in the country and 3% of registered voters in every legislative district. The People's Initiative for Modernization and Reform Action, or PIRMA, the group behind this effort, wants the Senate and House of Representatives to vote jointly instead of separately in approving amendments to the 1987 Constitution. According to COMELEC Chairman George Garcia, they have so far received signature forms from 400 cities and municipalities.
Ang role ng COMELEC ministerial lang. Titingnan lang kung tama yung bilang base po sa deklarasyon ng proponent.
COMELEC will have jurisdiction once a petition for a people's initiative is filed in the poll body and it is declared sufficient in form and substance. The poll body can then order the verification of signatures by election officers.
Titingnan po niya isa-isa yung signature sa bawat page, sa bawat form. Aalamin niya si Ava, registered voter. Active pa ba ang kanyang registration as a voter? And then titingnan niya po kung yun yung signature na lumalabas po sa aming voters registration record.
COMELEC will also determine if a voter willingly signed or if he was threatened or his signature was bought.
Ang tawag po natin dyan, madumi yung pirma na yan and pwede po ibaliwala yan ng ating local COMELEC.
Those who illegally acquired a signature may face charges.
Magsasagawa po kami ng preliminary investigation. Kung sakali man pong hindi election laws ang nalabag, ito naman po ay maaaring tugunan at imbisigahan ng ibang ahensya ng pamahalaan na may jurisdiction.
An example would be a violation of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act if public fund was used in getting a signature. Once signatures reach the required number, COMELEC will schedule a plebiscite where voters will decide whether the two houses of Congress should vote jointly or not. Garcia emphasized the need to carefully follow the law since amending the Constitution is a crucial act. He also reminded the public to scrutinize and understand documents they are being asked to sign. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Well, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri vows to step down from his post if political amendments in the Constitution pushes through. Zubiri's statement comes after concerns that the renewed push for charter change will involve political agenda, including the extension of terms of officials. The Senate President gives his assurance only economic provisions in the charter will be reviewed by the lawmakers. He adds, the Senate is ready to question the constitutionality of the ongoing push for People's Initiative before the Supreme Court.
I rest assure you, wala po tayong political amendments. It will be my political head at stake kung if kung merong may sisingit namang ganyan dito sa, at least sa amin sa Senado, hindi namin papasingit yan. If there will be a move like that, then I will resign as Senate President. It's as simple as that. We guarantee you, I guarantee you, it is only simple economic amendments to the economic provisions and para gumanda yung bansa at hindi para sa kapkanan ng ilang tao, lalo na sa mga politiko.
Meanwhile, at least one senator not pleased by the sudden turnaround in the chamber's stance on charter change.
Nung binasa to yung RBA 6, sabi ko na encounter natin to before. Hindi to bago. Dati, hindi siya naging attractive na proposition. Ngayon, biglang ang initiative lang galing na sa ilang senador. So magtataka ka, ano ba nangyari? Nasindak kami doon sa People's Initiative. Sindak masabi ng knee-jerk reaction.
Nearly half of Filipino families considered themselves poor in the fourth quarter of 2023. A survey by the Social Weather Station shows 47% of Filipino families rated themselves as poor. 33% said they felt borderline poor, while 20% said they did not feel it at all. The SWS estimates there were 13 million self-rated poor families in December 2023.